Hey, this morning has been one. This is not my regular mic, it quit working. Glory sliding after the other.
Dean.
Tom.
What are you doing this time?
I'm talking to Jesus. He's up there somewhere. I'm going to sing a little song about my life right now. And it goes something like this. Well, one day I went to get me some kind of accounting education. And then I got a job. But I liked capes and blacks. All of them. Gazebo and watching boats come in. Well, that little lucky boy that gave me that accounting degree, they taught me something about the net present value of a stream of money coming in. Imagine that. Sound boring at the time, and you had to look it up on the table. So Google net present value application, and you will find this information. Yeah, this is fun. Okay, so we got money coming in, and it's guaranteed, and it's over 10 years. You say, what discount rate? Well, right now about 5.25% is what we recommend. Well, how much every year? Well, right now they're saying guaranteed a minimum. We got a drum roll. $500 a year. That ain't ocean. That ain't that. It's clowns. Oh, I knew it was not clowns. 500 clowns. We're writing this song together, okay? 1,000. Take it at 10. That's above it. I said, like, how $500. $5 million in 10 years. But what I've tried is done financial projections. Well, I reviewed them on a $2 billion board, and I did them on a $100 million work plan. So, I don't know. I'm just saying, I know what I'm doing, right? I just said, hey, go do this and that, and then when you get to this point in your life, you'll know what you're doing. Seems to be happening with me. Okay, so this little piece of, here's a house. It's got a little tiki hut on the back. And then from there, you just see the sun go down. You see the ships go out. You see the seagulls sing. Give me another piece of bread, please. This little house is worth $4 million. What does it cost to buy it? $720. Oh, but I could get a nice rundown condo somewhere on the beach for that. Yeah, okay. Because the year after that, I could buy a. I plan to buy. I don't think I want to be on the Cape. I'm thinking more like going to Alaska. Maybe Puerto Rico. Buy some nights. The actual projections are one third of what I actually know it will make me happy. I'm making more like 1.5 million a year, and it's more like three times that figure is
this is worth $10 million for 750, which I only owe 720 now. I'd put $20,000 personal cash a roof. That's depends on where you're coming from and what you think that $20,000 is worth. But you know what? You know, how many people in this within the sound of my voice could have been there? Well, how did I get this deal? Well, we know who gave it to me. I called them. I wanted a campground site, and they're telling me they're selling it. They're selling it for $750. And I said, I think I'd like to get at least an option. First started out Christian retreat. Can't get it going. I mean, nobody is interested in going in and doing a Christian retreat because I like to sing gospel music. I thought, well, about better all this campground that you own, you got, you know, captive audience there. They should put that brochure. We do have one side effect that you're not gonna like, but just don't ever go to back deck when that guy's out there singing. Okay, so here we go. Good is gonna be singing, and then we'll be to singing three. This is good news. I'm gonna pause. It's $40,000. Give it to your friends that are hungry. You didn't probably know that some of you did, because I pick up a couple hundred of you a day, and I don't even know who you are either. They gave away $40,000, $40 at a time for 1,000 people and give somebody some money. I picked up a young man walking on the side of the road from Greenwood, and I decided to invest that money in a little bit more than him because he was walking to get groceries for his family about, you know, 5 miles around the trail. I don't think you gotta go far to see somebody that you just feel so sorry for and just wouldn't stop, even though they're a nice looking African man with a backpack and dressed nice and the thing in his ear and all, and he's not from Greenwood, he's a make up a happy kind of brown skinned man. There's a broken English, but he understood the money, he knew the need, and I made sure he knew the man that made it happen for the guy. So here we go. We gonna build a crew. Oh no, it's already there. We gonna get to know they're already coming. We gonna stop anybody that just wants to stop to the beach. Because we got Christians that we want to see at the beach. Not see people shooting at people. People running through the yard. They just killed somebody, they ran through my yard at the beach. Oh, it's a nice place. You can see Captain Anderson's and you can be at the beach in a minute. Hear the waves and observation deck. Cover the hot tub. That, I don't have possession of that. I went in there. We're gonna have a really nice little spot. Mr. Banker, oh, you want my house? You want the other life? The beach is worth about $400. You want my heart? No. So? No. I just want the 720. I'd like to go out the door.
How am I doing, guys?
They're still awake. How about this? I go to a store this morning. You know, silly me, I've changed hats. I didn't have a belt ball. Told the lady I'd be right back. It's only $1. It seemed like every time I turned around, I forgot my keys or something. I thought I had it when I started. I think I let the dementia strikes every 10 seconds or less than my age that hadn't lived through the 60s. But no. You feel my pain, you people. You know what I'm talking about. So what happens? Tell me more, tell me more. I pull up to the store, to the store. At the same time I pull up, a man is fixing to get in his vehicle right next door. And I roll my window down. Should I move over? Oh, I've got it. I said, I like your. You know, African-American, 65-year-old, he's got it all. I just told him he needed to do it with his beard too, it looked better. I don't know, it's a compliment. From that situation, he and I both said, you know, God works in mysterious ways. What is he doing? Well, he's got a cleaning business. He's up here falling behind his crews, and I heard some conversations that they were not doing well. And he gave him some good ministry advice, and it wouldn't have been what my pop had said. Okay, he's got like a half acre right there in Perry. He started a music venue, I guess, like down in Swanee, but it's in the middle of town. It's not an event. It's like St. Joe. Okay, we're going to do this. Let's do it every night. Whew. You see all this stuff? I don't need it. One speaker. One microphone. Maybe until let me sing a duet with him. Free to his. How much you going to charge? I said, free to you. Give me electrical plug. The kilowatt hours is what you charge. My man. He stays in one weekend. We got kick-started off in his business. What do we get? Video of a man singing for a crowd that 50,000 people have either said or thought, why is he not in Nashville? So I kind of got that situation, and then I got this situation, and then I got this guy up here. I'm working for him, and I'm like, can we slow down a little bit? You're overwhelming me here. He said, I would tell you to do it, but I didn't know you could do it. I said, please don't let me stay home and watch Christmas with all my friends. Miss Kitty, Matt wants kids. Miss Kitty's gone to heaven. She can't make children, but Sarah did. Some people don't know that Sarah gave birth at 19 years old. Oh, I think Abraham was like, I'm the man. No, he knew he was the man. All right, as usual, we run long, but I think the message today was probably worth your looking at some of it. The inside makings and workings of this fellow behind the mic is, if you can retire, you need to retire. Only if you're not going to watch Gunsmoke every day. If you're just going to go do it, you're more active. Keep working, keep going, keep moving. You know, so don't go home. You'll watch Gunsmoke and you'll wither away at night. And that's what's happening to our older generation. They got us where we're going. Well, a piece there. Okay. Anybody got anything to add? Of course, now that you've suffered through, if you have suffered through, if you don't take the thing out of here, hold your ear. I didn't mean to. I'm sorry. Yeah, that speaker out there could satisfy most needs in terms of outdoor singing. But one of them was... And then some others here at downtown Tallahassee. I don't think the Perry people want folks in Tallahassee coming down and messing their town up and eating and all. Thank the Lord, Charlie. We have got something we cannot have to redo. I know you guys are happy about that. Huh? Easter lilies, I hadn't turned on Gunsmoke. Mm-mm, I ain't doing it. I went through the process. I went through DTs. Yeah, kick that thing again, guys. I don't blame you. I'm pissed off too. No, I'm happy to have you. Hey, Bulldog, linebacker, we're discussing your future with some other people, and there's some people that said they believe in second chances, and I said, as long as somebody besides me or T's on you, we'll do a second chance, okay, Cowboy? Second chances.
Sport says, Daddy, he might kick me and kill me. Sport, not if you don't get under his feet. Sneaking around the mulberry tree. And somebody's saying they need something to eat. Well, all I'm saying about that, Percy, these people, at least you have the common courtesy of standing when your daddy comes. You know, trash plot, you know where it's at. We gotta get it. Somebody left the feet. Thanks for brushing me off like a, you don't love me. Man, I've had so many people do that in my life. And I don't feed them either. Yeah, again. All right, guys, I know, here's what's going on. If you get some newbies in, you wanna kinda let them mess around a little bit, and one thing leads to another, and that thing goes down there, and this thing that was over here is now over here, and that whole thing of hay that we, it's like, you know, whatever. Supplement. I don't see a much in there. Y'all did a good job. If y'all would go ahead and get this up. Now you, the girl, where were we going when I put that on you? Oh, well, I think we were going over to Riverside to get your Coggins test. And as one thing led to another, we decided Dr. Keller would be glad to come by and do that. We can't go to the caverns or go right on the beach until you get it. You know what I'm saying? You get, we're getting a little blood drawed. Okay, I think you're going to be all right with that. I have a young man going to move into the veteran's house. I think, you know, y'all know that I did the veteran's house, and the veterans are coming, the veterans are coming one by day and two by night. Well, I picked up a fellow today. He and his wife and 8-month-old baby are living where? Oh, those beautiful garden apartments. Don't that sound nice? Nice bunch of folks over there. No, he's going to be living in the veteran's house, and I hope he can get out here and pick up some of this crap. He actually has a full-time job. Working at a grocery store I won't mention. So this young man has a full-time job, but he's living in substandard. I don't know if you call it substandard. It's like, take your chances when you come in at night. Who knows, it might be wanting to grab you. That kind of place. It's a nice place, really. I actually know the woman that works for the company that developed a rehab there a few years ago. They specialize in getting the, you know what we call the grocery outlet, folks? That's what we call the ghetto outlet. Where's the ghetto? There you go. We got, everybody's got a ghetto. Ghetto. I hope he has time since he's not going anywhere. Well, I say that, two jobs, but now, first off, he gets off one morning. I take him to get his driver's license because it costs $50 to get him renewed, and he didn't have the $50 when it come time. And so then he'll be living here. He's still got to work at the grocery outlet. They pay so well. We don't want to find him another job. Like, oh, did I mention he is a United States veteran? Yep. We got a veteran coming, guys. And that little eight-month-old baby is going to be crying in there and all right there. But you put the mic on the baby, please. It's been a while. If you find anybody you can think of.